Hello everyone! In today's video, you will learn how to find what fonts are used in your PDF file and how to edit it. Sometimes you need to edit a PDF file, add annotations, or fill in PDF forms. So you want to use the same font in your documents. There are also times when you want to identify what font or fonts are used in an image or a logo. In certain situations, you may want to recreate a PDF file and use the same font. How do you identify the font used in a document? This video will show you how to overcome a common problem with PDF documents without installing additional applications such as Adobe Acrobat Pro or a similar app. I am using the preview application in this tutorial to view my PDF file. The preview app is in your applications folder. As you can see, some text and an image are in this PDF file. I want to know what font is used for this sentence. Some applications, such as Adobe Acrobat Pro, can display all the fonts used in a PDF file, but I don't want to purchase one just to know what fonts are used in a PDF document. All you need to do is take a screenshot of a couple of words and upload the screenshot to a website that can identify the font in your image. Before taking a screenshot, it's better to scale up the document by clicking on the zoom icon a couple of times. Then hold down Shift plus Command plus 4 on your keyboard, which turns the mouse cursor into a crosshair. Move the crosshair over the font, hold down the left button on your mouse, then drag the crosshair to select the font. Once you are happy with your selection, release the mouse button. A screenshot will appear on your desktop. Next, launch your web browser and go to MyFontscom. Click on the What the Font drop-down menu and select What the Font. Scroll down to see the dotted line box. Drag your screenshot to the box. And resize the crop box if necessary. Then click on the arrow and wait for the website to display the name of the font used in the screenshot. If it cannot find the exact font name, it will show a similar one. In this case, Coaching is the font that I am looking for. I don't think I have Engraver's old style on my system. Note down the font name, in my case, Coaching, and return to your PDF viewer. Click on the markup icon to reveal the editing tools. Next, click on the text style icon. Then click on the arrow to search for the font in the font drop-down menu. And select the font you need. Let's say we want to change this sentence from what fonts to which fonts and make the font size bigger. The preview app is not a full-fledged PDF editor. I can't delete this sentence. However, I can hide it with a trick and add my text. To conceal a sentence or a phrase, click on Shapes and drag a rectangle over your sentence. As soon as you click on one of these shapes, you get a warning that says, "The content behind this annotation will not be deleted." Click OK. Drag the rectangle over your text and resize it if necessary. Next, click on the text icon. Type your sentence. Select it and change your font to match the font in your PDF document. In my case, it's coaching. And resize it as you wish. I'll change it to 30. Finally, place it where you want it to be. I changed what fonts to which fonts. In the second example, we want to fill in an application form using the same font. As before, I click on the zoom icon to scale up my PDF. It would be better to enlarge the font so that the website can accurately identify it. After scaling up, I hold down Shift plus Command plus 4 to take a screenshot. Next, I go to myfonts.com. Drag the screenshot to the dotted line box. Resize the crop box. And click on the arrow. The font name is Typewriter. I'll return to my PDF document. Click on the text icon, and from the drop-down menu, I look for the font typewriter. It's the American typewriter font. I'll type my name and resize it if necessary. To fill the rest of the application form, I'll hold down the Option key, click on the text box, and drag the box to duplicate it. By duplicating the text box, we want to ensure that we use the same font and size. Type my family name and place it in front of the family name. You can do the same for the telephone number and the address. Then drag the text box and place it where you want it to be. If you need to delete a text box, click on it and press the delete key on your keyboard. In the third example, we want to know what font is on this happy birthday card. Again, take a screenshot by holding down Shift plus Command plus 4. Drag your image to the dotted line box and wait for the website to identify the font. Here, the font name is Alex Brush Rob. This font doesn't come with macOS. You can search for it on Google. If it is a commercial font, you must purchase a license to use it. Finally, there is one point you need to bear in mind. Even after saving your file, the rectangle and text layers can be moved around. If you want to keep the position of your text and images fixed, first, save your PDF file in PostScript format by pressing Command plus P to open the print dialog box. Then, select Save as PostScript from the drop-down menu. Name your file, for example, PostScript, make sure desktop is selected, and click Save. To save your PostScript file as a PDF, first open the PostScript file. Press Command plus P to open the print dialog box again. Then select Save as PDF. Name your file. For example, PDF2. Make sure desktop is selected and click on Save. Now, if you open your PDF file, and click on the rectangle text box or images, you will notice their positions are fixed and remain invisible. If you want to know how to add images to a PDF file, I have another tutorial on my channel. This one. I leave the link in the description underneath this video. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you learned something new from it, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you want to receive notifications about future tutorials. Thank you for watching.